Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. In today's video, we will be diving into the brand new timeline view that is available inside of Notion, and it's rolling out as we speak. There's also a few additional updates, including page customization, that I want to run through in today's video. So without further ado, folks, let's roll into today's video. So before we begin, if you want to learn about Notion, including all about this new timeline view update, you can check out the lessons that are available inside of Notion Made Simple. The first module is free and you can check it out below. So let's start with the timeline view. This has actually weirdly been teased for over a year now, and I was pretty excited about this new update coming because I quite like Gantt charts to some extent in allowing you to visualize data, and this new timeline view will allow you to do that inside of databases. So to start, the timeline view can be added either inline or full page database. So this is actually the sixth view that you can access a database in. You can view table, list, calendar, board, gallery, and now timeline view. So when you go ahead and create a timeline view, you get three cards that are preset, much like you do if you create a board or another type of database. So you can actually hover and add a card at any time and pop the cards tray open to see what cards you have in there in this page view if you want to. Now, what's really nice is if you have a, say, a database calendar with everything inside of that database calendar with end dates and start dates, then you can actually change the view to timeline and automatically see all of those projects or cards all mapped out and plotted out in timeline view. So this view actually helps people who have already got projects maybe set up or events and information like that projected from a start to an end date. So all you have to do is switch to the different view for that. However, if you don't actually want to add an end date, this will automatically do this for you if you're plotting them out inside of this view. So one of the things that is most impressive in this timeline view is the actual ability to change the time that you view the timeline on. So for example, you could have a regular month view, which we're seeing automatically, but you can actually choose bi-weekly, week, day, and even hour view. Now, the reason I want to go into this is because the hour view could actually be quite useful for people that are organizing events or meetings, which really enhances the way that you use this timeline view. But it could be a good way to plot out an event or an activity that you may be running and actually see them by time based, which is very useful, especially when you're planning things to the granular level. So obviously I might not necessarily recommend this for calendar blocking because obviously it is quite difficult in the timeline view, but I did change it back to the calendar view and found that it actually matched it quite nicely without interrupting the natural flow of the database. So there is that ability if you did have a couple of projects or staff members that you were working with, you wanted to assign them specific activities or things per hour to work on, then that could be something that you did there. This could also be useful for someone using time tracking if they wanted to block their time and see where they spent specific portions of their time throughout the day. So one of the other major updates is the ability to customize a page a little further than you used to. So you can go into the top right hand corner and press customize page, and this works for both databases and regular pages. So inside of a database, you can actually customize the sections to start. You can choose whether you want to show backlinks or comments. I'll come back to this. But the real magic is the ability to customize the properties. So for example, if you wanted to hide certain things so you didn't have a stupidly extensive long properties list, you can now do that. So you can actually choose to always show, hide when empty, or always hide. And this is something that might help people when it comes to making a little bit more of attractive areas or places that you regularly visit and you want to hide specific things, but only pop them open when you need them. This is actually something I've done for the videos section because I actually don't use all of the sections every single time, but when I do, I can pop them open and see all of the properties I need. So when it comes to regular pages, you can go to the top right hand corner and customize the page and choose whether you want to see backlinks completely off or whether you want to show them in pop-up or have them always open. And the same goes with comments as well. This is particularly helpful if you're someone that isn't in a team and you don't necessarily want to see comments distracting the page. So page customization just makes it easier to make your page look more visually beneficial when you're using it more routinely. Okay, something I won't jump into in today's video is actually two additional updates, which are advanced page permissions. So you can now edit permissions of subpages, which is something that you weren't able to do before. And also you can now limit inline database rows. So all in all, this new timeline view adds a new view for your databases. The customized pages makes it easier to access and manipulate what you see on the page, but just when you're routinely visiting pages, it definitely helps it to be a lot more organized and better for everyday use. So folks, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do check out the Notion Made Simple course. As I said, we're adding a few lessons for timeline view, and we're also adding monthly lessons now. So please do join us there if you want to, and I'll see you all very soon. Anyway, folks, thank you very much. Cheerio.